नमस्कार ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, फ्रेंड्स, स्कॉलर्स, स्टूडेंट्स, कोलीग्स, प्रोफेशनल्स एंड ऑफिशियल्स, एडवर्टाइजर्स एंड मीडिया पर्सनल, डॉक्टर्स एंड मिस्टर्स, आई हार्टली वेलकम ऑल दोज हु आर प्रोवाइडिंग देयर वैल्यूएबल एंड प्रेशियस टाइम इन लिसनिंग द ट्रूथ ऑफ आवर कंट्री, द ट्रूथ ऑफ आवर नेशन. टुडे नाउ एंड हियर we are discussing the very important history, autobiography of the person whose picture and photo is on our currency, who is the source of inspiration, motivation, encouragement and the source and medium of meeting, conversing, communicating for everyone, child to man, bottom to top, root to fruit, all are bounded with the currency. So that personality who devote and dedicate for the nation, about that personality many facts we know, because his birthplace is Gujarat, the same place as our present Prime Minister, our present Honorable Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, who also born in Gujarat and who also believes in the ideas, thoughts, notions of Gandhi. He started many programs and promoted Mahatma Gandhi for his actions of nationality of our country and society. His living style was modest and simple in living, but his thinking was very high for the nation and society. His every step today is the inspiration and encouragement for the development of our country. Gandhi, who came in India in 1914, before that he was in South Africa, he completed his barrister in South Africa, became advocate and came in India fighting for the workers, laborers of Bihar and Maharashtra, where there was industries and the laborers were not given the salaries and wages in exchange of their works. So he fought for them, striked for them. Gandhiji was very instrumental in 1914 to 1947, so the age, the whole time is known as Gandhiism. 1914, it was the time of starting the first world war at the world level. And the foreigners want that India should involve and participate from them to fight for them, for their nation. But due to truth, the truth and non-violence of Gandhiji, our country do not involve in them for fighting for any, in any moment if there was violence. Gandhiji strongly took back the action and stopped the movement. Rightly, when there was violence, when there was inhuman activities, he was against them. So it is also rightly said by our present Prime Minister that our nation is the nation of Gandhi and Buddha, whose message is that the truth and non-violence. So this is the first step for our Indians, for our culture, for our nation, that we follow. First step to the truth and non-violence. On this basis, on this doctrine, on this principle, our present Prime Minister has started a number of initiatives. The initiatives that, the objective of the initiative is humanity, humanitarian services for the welfare of humanity. He started many programs. There is the glimpse of Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi sent the congressmen to villages as messengers of the new gospel of action. The new gospel of action. The peasants emerged from their quiescent shell. The effect of these visits was far-reaching. We learnt about Indian more from these visits than from learned books. Gandhiji was a staunch believer of that thoughts. He wrote in his Gandhian philosophy that a master should be the master of his subject. He should have full command on his subject. There should not be the need of any book, because a teacher, a master himself is the guide and book of the students, for their scholars, for their disciples. We learnt about Indian more from these visits, from these visits than from learned books. Wherever Gandhiji was, there was his friends. Their eating style, sleeping style, their meeting style was common for all the students. Those who were learning, those who were studying in the universities, he spent a lot of time with them, for becoming friendly and fearlessly with them. For knowing internally them, Gandhiji spent a lot of time with them, for improving their skills, for improving their talents. Gandhiji hold strong views on economics, social and other matters. He did not try to impose all these on the Congress. Not many people accepted his views in their entirely. Some disagreed, but many accepted them in modified form. Gandhiji's principle and doctrine was too intuit, insight, insight, intuition, spirituality, internal study, inner study. These were his great tools that he applied for reforming, for improving the student's skill, talent. Gandhi was essentially a man of religion. He was a religious politician. He was away from the evils. Which evils? Which are done by eyes, ears, and tongue. For that he says, don't see bad things, don't listen bad things, and don't speak bad things. His aim was not on the bad. His aim was not to say the things are bad. His aim was to say that neither a Hindu nor a Muslim is bad. A person who sins upon his bed means evil is bad. Man is not bad. His lesson was truly a great for the nation. He was a great philosopher and psychologist. He was a man of religion. He was a Hindu to the innermost depths of his being. But his conception of religion had nothing to do with any dogma or ritual. Truth and non-violence appeared to him to be different aspects of one and the same thing. He used these terms almost interchangeably. He said, I declined to be a slave to precedents or practice. I cannot understand or defend on a moral basis. In practice, he was free to take the path of his choice and to change and adapt himself to his own philosophy of life. Whether that philosophy is right or wrong may be argued, but he insists on applying the same fundamental